选门窗设计安全，样样都要考虑周全。怎样为家中挑选最合适的门窗？单身公寓几经周折终于完工，到底独特在哪里？这一期的幸福有家马上为您揭晓答案。观众朋友们大家好，假期刚过，大家有没有邀请朋友到家里来做客，举办一个热闹的 party 呢？在上一集中，单身汉 Bradley 的家终于装修完成，他邀请了很多好朋友，小小的家竟然容纳下了几十人，他的家到底变成了什么样呢？一起去看一看。
经过两年的时间， Bradley 终于完成了自己心目中的单身汉公寓。现在该是让 Devon 为我们揭开谜底的时候了。
Tell me a little bit about the kitchen. It's got some unique features.
One of the things I've always found when I've had been to other people's houses parties, everybody wants to congregate in the kitchen.
所以 Bradley 的厨房少不了娱乐的元素。
Put in a custom built beer trough for when I'm having parties and such.
而旁边就是存酒的酒柜，打开冰箱，里面也装满了各式各样的酒，还不止这些。
Okay, so tell me a little bit about what's behind the bar here.
Behind the cabinet here is an industrial blending machine or slurping machine. When I have parties and entertain, that's a really popular feature.
当朋友来拜访，原本的客厅会立刻变身，容纳更多的人。
So this is how I would set up the apartment for if I was throwing a party that wasn't going to be focused around the TV, more for entertaining.
如此一来，便与客厅、厨房融为一体。
And so then to change it back, what I do is move these out of the way.
积木式的沙发的好处就是可以任意组合。在开派对的时候，沙发可以向外摆，增添空间；而平时则可以向内摆，观看电视。此时的客厅变成了家庭厅。虽然这是 Bradley 的单身汉公寓，但是在设计中也不乏家庭气息。
This is the EcoSmart fire system, and the way it works is it's denatured alcohol.
点燃壁炉，这里立刻充满了温馨的气息。 Bradley 说，其实在他的设计中，除了为自己考虑，也考虑到了家庭生活。
As well as coffee system, which does cappuccinos or lattes, convection steam oven, as well as a full convection oven.
那么烹饪的炉子在哪里呢？原来是采用了隐藏式的设计。
I went with the Gaganu hob systemwhich have a griddle and then double burner and double induction for in the kitchen.
Bradley 虽然自己不烹饪，但是甚至都为家庭考虑到了洗碗的问题。
And I put in two so I never have to actually unload my dishwasher. So I decided to go with the magic corner.
家用电器可谓是应有尽有。
It's quite popular in Europe to have the laundry in the kitchen.Well, has the ironing board.
同时，储藏空间也是不少。
So there's lots of storage throughout the apartment.
接下来就到了主卧，当然也就是唯一的卧室。保留下来的墙面充满了复古的味道。
I really like sleeping in a cold room. I like a warm bed.Cold room and quiet and dark.
而在复古的气氛中，高科技也悄悄布满了整个房屋。
So one of the other features is the lighting, the control system. So if I push this button once, it'll turn off all the lights in the house. And if I push the same button four times,
这样就不需要每晚都走遍屋内去关每个灯的开关了。
I did a control four system. For example, I can control the lighting.So I can control the blinds, turn on the TVs, turn on the radio.
如此一来，现代的高科技与复古的装修设计融洽地结合在了一起。
What's your favorite feature of the home?
For me, it's the bathroom, shower, the bathtub.
而且当他沐浴时还可以看电视，不过电视在哪里呢？只要将面板打开就可以看到了。
Jesse shower head that has the different lighting controls, so you can change the color to just about any color you want. And some of the neat features of the shower are the mist, the rain, as well as the waterfall, and the body jet.
整个房屋的点点滴滴，从一室一厅的格局，到娱乐设施，再到高科技产品，都非常符合单身汉 Bradley 的生活方式。前前后后3年的装修时间并不算短，而当时因为受伤所产生的沮丧心情，如今一扫而光。回想当初 ，Bradley 认为挫折总会存在，但是只要不放弃，事情总会顺利地进行下去。
虽然是个单身公寓，可里面的精心设计与构思可却是独具一格。上期的节目中我们介绍了门，这次我们将为您介绍窗。现在家中一般都是选推拉窗，很容易积攒污垢，而且窗户外面不能清洁。有没有什么办法可以解决这些问题呢？我们一起看下去。
Jenny 今天要去一家门窗公司选购窗户，她想选择什么样式的窗户呢？
Thanks for coming to the showroom.
因为呢，家里呢想要在西温那边建一个新房，那我就是来这边看一下，就是新的门窗。因为跟以前的房子不同呢，这次呢在西温建呢，想要建比较高档一点的，那选择性呢就希望稍微可以选择的材料更好一些，那门窗的款式更特别一点。
DYJ 门窗公司的销售经理 David 接待了 Jenny。Jenny 希望找到一些比较高档的窗户，那么 David 会从哪儿开始介绍呢？
We've got two very popular models here. It's the casement design. These windows are hinged on their side. We also have them available where they're hinged on the top, and that design is called an awning window. These designs open outwards.
这些款式的窗户在市场上比较多见。接下来 ，David 介绍的第二种设计有些特别。
One of the latest developments here, and something that's becoming more and more popular in North America, is a product we call tilt and turn. So we have three functions. We have the lock, we have tilt for fresh air.
这种窗户一开始不熟悉的话，以为窗户会掉下来，当然还可以正常的开启。
Now the other operation for the window is turn, and this allows you to have safe.Easy cleaning from inside the home.
这种设计结合了窗子侧开和向外开的特点，使得用户可以在不同的气候情况下选择不同的开窗方式。在安全方面，这种窗户的设计也有着全面的考虑。
Security on this window is provided by multi-point locking points that surround the perimeter of the frame, so that when we close the window, we actually lock it in many places.And not just rely on the sash side the way we have with casements or awning. Another thing with the window then for security is also our glazing. So it's heat strengthened what we call tempered glass that is 5 times more stronger than normal what we call annealed glass.
Jenny 听完介绍后觉得不错，自己上去一试身手，感觉还不错。
Correct.
但似乎这些窗子都是金属的，有没有木头的呢？
And I'd like to show you the hybrid product here then, is different than most solidly built wood windows. So what we have here in the hybrid is a unique combination of the aluminum window. They stand up very well and are extremely durable in our seacoast environment. Inside is finished with a hardwood or a softwood.
外面的材料虽然是铝材，但做的和木头很相似。铝材可以很好的防腐蚀。而室内一面是实木材料，达到了美观的要求。Jenny 觉得单面窗的面积太小 ，David 说也可以把两扇窗制作成一扇，避免了当中的竖梁。同时，考虑到家外面的风景不错 ，David 建议采用另外一种设计。
You mentioned on your home as you have that beautiful outdoor living space that comes up against the interior living space, and then it might be nice to enjoy both at the same time. So that can be done with folding doors. So we have a swing door at the end, and then we have a series of panels that will open outwards to move and stack this entire door over to one side. So that will give you the feeling that outdoors is indoors.
虽然折叠门不错，但似乎关着窗时数量太多。这里也有推拉门的设计，适合大尺寸的门窗，避免了很多的数量而影响欣赏风景。
So this is an aluminum version of our lift and slide door. It has the similar advantages of locking or dropping the door in any position you'd like to locate the panel.
这种推拉门的另一个好处是安全性能高，只要把手柄放下来锁住，根本无法再移动。但解锁后推起来却非常轻，而且可以锁在任何一个位置。只要外面的人手伸不进来，你可以放心的睡觉，空气还能流通。至于玻璃，因为采用了双层5毫米的钢化玻璃，想敲碎玻璃强行进入是不可能的。在很多案子中，就是因为后院推拉门的质量不好而导致入室偷窃。了解完窗户的一些新功能， Jenny 很受启发，决定让 David 来帮他进行新屋的门窗设计。商量完一些具体的设计细节后， Jenny 满意的回家了。接下来就是等着公司派人来具体测量尺寸了。
好了，这一期的幸福有家时间又到了。如果您有任何建议和问题，一定与我们联系。美好生活，幸福有家，我们下期同一时间再见。